Sport holds a precious, almost vague place in my heart. Do I know much about it? Maybe not. But that doesn't stop me from holding it very dear. Yes, bats, rackets, and all those balls. There really is something for everyone when it comes to the proud tradition of sports in Two Point County.
I'm Felicity Bellbottoms, and you're listening to Campus Radio. Later in the show, we'll be discussing another hot student topic. Old meat. How grey is too grey? That and much, much more coming right up.
Tuition fees are expensive. An education is priceless. You students should make a good first impression. No pressure. Now taking students for academic exercise. Questions. Yes, we are testing you. Students are reminded to be in two places at once.
Education Minister Tarquin Foxbridge has once again stoked the fire between his department and the county's student unions, saying, "Tuition fees will rise and they must rise. I spend more on loafer wax than most students do on their entire education. It's just not fair." Thanks, Minister, for that much-needed, albeit clueless, perspective.
Talking on campus. Education is non-refundable. Thank you.
lectures can, if done incorrectly, be quite boring. But here's our preview of a lecture that has students everywhere wide awake. Avant-garde academic and student darling Omar Figgins began his latest series of touring lectures this week. The early reviews are in for the talk entitled, What We Talk About When We Talk About What We Talk About. One student had this to say. It was great. I barely understood any of it. So, you can imagine. Wow. Reserve your tickets for his visit to your campus today. You won't want to miss it.
Janitor required in lecture theatre. Don't eat homework. Is expanding even more than usual. No, your chicken should not be pink.
At Jumbo, we know it's our employees that are the big deal. That's why they get the Jumbo treatment. Mobile stationery, toilet substitute, sip of milk, leg rooms, dental surgeries, additional headrest, and our famous data system analysis training program system, or FDAPSTAPS. I'm Jumbo McNally, and I wish I worked here.
Announcement. Plants need water, remember? Mm-hmm. intended to be inspirational. Students are reminded to set reminders. It's too late to start trying.
Finally, the matter of grey meat. Yes. Health Inspector Henry Jobsworth, who sent us a very comprehensive 7,000-word report on the subject, asked for a snappier response, more suitable for radio. He had this to say: if it's just turned grey, it might be okay. If it's been grey for a while, it's sure to be hostile. Well, if it rhymes, it's probably true.
The academic year is over. Students must vacate the campus. The end of year results have been released. Luck won't help you now. The summer break would be a convenient time for construction. Return to the hospital. Thank you. Hitting the books doesn't mean what you think it means. it's not your year, it's just another year. Welcome, new students. We're more afraid of you than you are of us. Students are reminded that you came here on purpose. Distracted students should pretend that they're listening.
Now that's easy listening. The sound of Two Point County on Two Point Radio. You're listening to Two Point Radio, the place your ears call home. We've got a barnstorming show for you today. But before we kick down the door and go straight for the valuables, soak in some sonic excellence. Play that track and we'll be right back.
Unattended sandwiches will be eaten by me.
In the news today, I seem to have sat on something sharp. We're not sure exactly what it is or what the consequences might be, but we'll update you as soon as we know more.
Can you see it? Is it in me? Tell me it's not in me.
Janitor required for groundskeeping. Thank you. Tuition fees may be spent on administrative bonuses. Students are asked not to ask questions.
Wouldn't you know, I'd sat at a sprig of holly from yesterday's lunch. That's the risk you run when adding a little pizzazz to your meal. But that won't stop me. It's not the first piece of holly I've sat on, and it certainly won't be the last.
Students are reminded to find themselves. Thank you. frequently asked questions. No, you can't have an extension.
I'm Jumbo McNally, and at Jumbo University, every instructor is handpicked by someone that was handpicked by someone that I handpicked. That's the Jumbo Touch. Jumbo University, be your biggest self.
Two Point Radio, the station that puts the stabilizers on the bike of your day. It's Ricky Hawthorne. The time is... Anyone got the time? No? They told me I'd regret putting sundials in the booth. There aren't even any windows, they said. Oh, how we laughed. More timeless radio after this silky little number.
Warning. Stupid questions will make you look stupid. Has now been published. schedule your lives accordingly. Welcome, new students. We're more afraid of you than you are of us.
Chef Ricky here, bringing you a morsel of the day. We all like a boiled egg, but wouldn't you love one on the go? Just imagine, you're stuck in traffic and bang, a boiled egg just for you. You see, eggs have a casing or shell that's perfect for keeping the egg safe. Why, I've got two boiled eggs in my pocket right now. Give it a try.
If you don't know where your class is, is it really worth going? Project complete. Intruders on campus, oh no. Mm-hmm.
I've just eaten a pocket egg. How are you? I must remember to boil another batch and take them to my next book club meeting. Yes, I've been in a book club since I was a boy, and this is my fifth attempt at The Salty Minstrel, one of the county's first books. I really do struggle with the old language. In fact, I think the only words that are the same are salty and minstrel. You'd think it was enough, but it's not. It's time for the question of the week. We asked, which instrument is the funniest? We had some great replies, including quite a few we can't read on air. You're a vocalot, you really are. Knock knock, who's there? The answer who? The answer is the trombone. Now that is funny. I'll be laughing until next time. Fare thee good and fare thee well. Good night.
The administrator is reminded to stay hydrated. such thing as free time. It's not on your CV. It didn't happen. Not to me.
I'm DJ Shorts, the host giving you the most on Campus Radio. It's been too long, and I've been dying to play this next song. See if you notice what they do on the ninth bar in the second verse. Oh, it's really something. We'll be back after this.
The more you revise, the longer you've been revising. Students are reminded that this is the fun part. Intruders on campus. You know what to do.
Who even goes to the student union? When I want a milkshake, I don't want a pint of milkmaid. It's so artificial, I just can't take it anymore. I'd much rather go a little off the beaten path and try something local. And preferably very lumpy. Anything from the stomach churner dairy and Smogley is sure to be nice and separated. Now that's a milkshake.
is cold because the oven wasn't on. Security breach. Please change your passwords. Sorry.
And now, a segment about a student taking an exam.
Bertie had been up all night preparing for an important test. He'd done the revision, he'd set his alarms, but then, some hours later, disaster struck. It was as he finished his paper that he realized he hadn't been using a pen. He thought he was dotting I's and crossing T's, but sadly, he was just making gestures with his hand over a piece of paper. It's a nightmare for so many of us, but today, it was Bertie's reality.
Doctor, return to the hospital. Thank you. Is not a belief system. Completed a marketing project. Nicely done.
Mm-hmm. What am I going to do with my life? I just don't know.
Orb.
Huh? What?
Come to an Orb Foundation Learning Center and replace your mind with the power of the Orb.
Oh, amazing. I'll do that then. Thanks.
Frequently asked questions. Yes, we are testing you. Approaching the end of the academic year. Try not to worry.
Been waiting for this, and now you have. I'm finally gonna talk about the Boogie Nights. I'm sure I didn't need to tell you that I was actually in on the group of Funky Nights very, very early, and I thought they were a real bright spot in the county's music scene. But I must say, I'm just not enjoying them as much these days. I mean, really, I know I like them, but they just shouldn't be this popular. Another perfectly excellent obscure band ruined by too many fans. It's just selfish. It really is.
The end of year results have been released. Luck won't help you now. Students are reminded that some
Nigel Bickleworth.
Cheers, cheers!
On 2 Point Radio, salutations and congratulations on your exquisite taste. You are tuning in for the peak of sophistication on our county's airwaves, Sir Nigel Bickleworth on 2 Point Radio. But of course, you already knew that.
We've just completed a marketing project. Nicely done. maintenance announcement. Plants need water, remember? Intruders on campus, oh no. There's a fly in here.
It's time for Sir Nigel Reviews. And thanks to the enlightening intervention of our wonderful producers, you, the audience, have chosen the object of our desires this week. The public's collective wisdom has entrusted me with hog logs. I'm told a popular choice of breakfast cereal. Let's get this over with, shall we? Mm-hmm. Interesting. Interesting. It almost tastes like pork scratchings. Oh!
Research project. Well done. Thank you.
Apologies for the abrupt end to our last segment. I've had a quick rinse and can commence with our review. The border of sweet and savory is, for some perverse reason, the fashion in fine dining circles, so I suppose it only makes sense that this would trickle down in some form to the food of the layperson. Congratulations to you, the common people, for joining in on this most foul of fads.
Intruders on campus. Oh no. Please drink some water. Thank you. Approaching the end of the academic year. Try not to worry.
At Milkmaid, we use real dairy-style ingredients in our milkshakes for a level of consistency that just isn't natural. Meaning that every glass of Milkmaid is eerily similar to the last.
Wow!
Mmm, Milkmaid. Now that's good milk. Not technically milk.
The academic year is now over. Year results have been released. Luck won't help you now. Summer break would be a convenient time for construction. The timetable is not written in stone. Still, we're not changing it. students are reminded that you came here on purpose.
Nigel Bickleworth, your friend over the frequencies. I tried to get this next song pulled from the station, but alas, what can one do? Well, I can play it with the disclaimer that you shouldn't enjoy it, and you won't enjoy it. Here you are, some musical tripe, only on 2-Point Radio.
Talking on campus. Thank you. Congratulations. Research project complete.
It's time to spill the tea with Nigel B. Nigel B?
Who wrote that? Who wrote it? Have them fired, all right?
Today I'm hearing that a production assistant at a certain radio station is getting the sack. Scandalous, I know, but you didn't hear it from me. It may come as a shock, but in my formative years, I went through a gothic phase. I know, it's hard to imagine, but to a young and impressionable Bickleworth, there was nothing more exciting than a flying buttress. And the gargoyles, so pensive, so lugubrious, so stony. Of course, I'd come to my senses and learn to love the provocative opulence and theatricism of the Baroque. We live and we learn.
If you don't know where your class is it really worth going? cold because the oven wasn't on.
Auntie Pickleworth, because it's time for Agony Answers. Today's anguish comes from Patronized in Pebbly. My elder sister talks down to me. It's like we're still kids. How can I get her to take me seriously? Oh no, how dreadful. What a very serious and adult problem you have. My advice, grow up. And of course, tune in again next time. Ta-ta!
Intruders on campus. You know what to do. To have the time of their lives. Here, in case you haven't noticed. starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do? The academic year is over. Students must vacate the campus. End of year results are now available. No unauthorized panicking. Sorry for the litter that you... Oh, sorry, that's mine.
Maggie Watmore, learning on the job on Campus Radio. Can I ask, should we be paying someone for using this next song? Sorry, I just really don't know. Anyway, I'm sure it'll be fine. Here we go.
Frequently asked questions. No, I will not be your friend. That's not on your CV. It didn't happen. Not to me.
Everyone on campus is talking about the county's education minister and the bad, or maybe good, thing that happened. Over to you, Hugh.
Yes, that's right. Emotions are high here in Crockenbush today as students have flooded into the city to protest the continued existence of education minister Tarquin Foxbridge. They dabbled in some chanting, but haven't been able to get into an easy and repeatable rhythm. We'll be here letting you know the wording they settle on as and when it happens.
Skills are non-transferable. Intruders, please not come in.
Do you want to learn better? Of course you do. Wanda, how do we do that? everyone is looking for ways to study without all those hours in the library and pen stains on your fingertips. The latest way to trick your body into learning is to sleep with a book in front of or on top of your face. As you sleep, your eyes will occasionally open, letting in a little light and valuable, valuable knowledge. Try it for a week and see the results for yourself.
Distracted students should pretend that they're listening. Tuition fees are expensive, and education is priceless.
At Bungle, we know what young people want in a motor vehicle. Independence. Fun.
Woohoo!
Wheels. Beaver from Bungle. The car that puts the E in freedom.
Tuition fees may be spent on administrative bonuses. visitors on campus. Oh no.
And that's the show. Join us tomorrow when we'll be discussing which vegetables last the longest. That should be great. You know, I've bought 16 avocados this year and still haven't gotten to eat any of them. I mean, really, they must be ripe for about 5 minutes. Sorry, we'll leave that for tomorrow, shall we? Join us then.
Students are asked not to ask questions. Year, in case you haven't noticed. The timetable is now live. questions will make you look stupid.
Harrison Wolf on Two Point Radio. Welcome to Two Point Radio. This is Harrison Wolf, and I will be your host of this little sonic get-together. This is the party within the party. The sandwich and the lunchbox. The thing in the thing. I'll think of some words, and we'll be right back.
Visitors should be checked in and then removed immediately. Questions. No, I will not be your friend.
the news today, local film star Roderick Cushion is in a spot of bother after he was photographed throwing a bagel at some photographers. It's pretty bad luck that those freelance photographers were in his bathroom at the exact moment he decided to start flinging bagels. I mean, what are the chances?
Hard work may or may not pay off. Administrator is reminded to stay hydrated. Students are reminded that you came here on purpose.
I've lived in Two Point County for more years than I can remember, but every now and then I still hear an expression for the first time. This morning, I bumped into Ricky Hawthorne, and after a nice chat, he says, "Time to see a man about a dolphin." I have no idea what it could mean. Don't tell me though, that man's an enigma, and I choose to keep him that way.
Tuition fees are expensive, and education is priceless. Students are reminded to be in two places at once. intruders on campus. Oh no. Yes, we are testing you.
Hi, I'm Jumbo McNally, and at Jumbo University, every instructor is handpicked by someone that was handpicked by someone that I handpicked. That's the Jumbo Touch. Jumbo University, be your biggest self.
We're approaching the end of the academic year. Try not to worry. Thank you.
Carson Wolf, talking the days away on Two Point Radio. We got a lot more radical radio for you today. There will be music, there will be speaking, and if we're lucky, we'll have some county-shaking news that'll make us see life differently forever. But first, I gotta find my pencil. Wish me luck.
Maintenance announcement. Plants need water, remember?
Pretty sweet segment lined up for you, but my producer is waving his arms at me through the glass. Yep, waving back hasn't seemed to help much. I'll see what he has to say while you listen to my new favorite song.
Announcement. Intruders on campus. Oh no. not a belief system.
Sorry about that confusion. It was nothing serious. My producer just had certain opinions about the content I had planned. I like being censored as much as the next guy, but little did they know, they can't stop me thinking about it. The brain is the last refuge of the so-called undesirable thought. It's a party up there, and boy, is it a fun one.
Students are reminded that I'm not your mum. Not a real announcement. Security breach. Please change your passwords. Sorry. Intruders on campus. You know what to do. Sorry for the litter that you... Oh, sorry, that's mine.
that's it for today's show. I don't know if it's been a classic, but who am I to say? These things need to marinate in the passing of time. Only then will we know if today was a classic day. Who knows? Maybe what I'm saying right now is making or breaking the show. Have I just ruined it? What about now? Trippy. I'll be back for more radio in the future.
Announcement. The campus just got bigger. Not necessarily better. Students are reminded that there's no such thing as free time. Approaching. It's too late to start trying. Starting soon. Was there anything you wanted to do? The yearly results are in. Wow, didn't we do well? Welcome, new students. We're more afraid of you than you are of us. Announcement. The timetable is now live. announcement. We've just completed a marketing project. Staff are reminded to care about students.
This is Campus Radio, and I'm your host, Felicity Bellbottoms. Speculation continues to build over that smell in the lecture theatre. But what should you believe? Did someone really stuff a block of cheddar under one of the seats? Or is it haunted? The answer may surprise you.
Skills are non-transferable. Education is non-refundable. Intruders, please not come in. Time for a book review. Over to Maggie, who's been reading the memoirs of Two Point Radio's longest tenured DJ.
This week, I've been reading A Life on the Waves by Ricky Hawthorne. Oh, so good. Really, really good. Because I didn't know before, actually, that he spent so much time at sea. Or, well, near any water, really, and that's just super interesting.
Janitor required for groundskeeping. Thank you. Visitors should be checked in and then removed immediately.
Renovation of a library might sound like a good thing, but here's Hugh to tell us why it's actually quite sad.
Here in Smogley, students have been looking forward to the renovation of the old campus library. The carpet is plush and the study areas are dressed with kettles and beanbags. The library is alive and bustling, but the old bookcases are left on the outside, looking in. Yes, three old bookcases stand on the lawn outside the library, a monument to a past that's now over. Spare a thought for them as you enjoy a sleek, frictionless library experience.
Students are reminded that some grades are personal.
Thank you.
frequently asked questions. No, your chicken should not be pink. Intruders on campus. You know what to do.
Hey, guys, hear me out. What if we went back to school?
It started as a class reunion and ended with them back in class.
That's crazy! Hey, I'm climbing on a statue. Everybody get in the shed! I can't revise anymore. My knees hurt.
Roderick Cushion is varsity freshman in Immature Students.
Warning, stupid questions will make you look stupid. It's too late to start trying. Starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do? The academic year is now over. End of year results published.
And there we have it. It's being reported that that smell in the lecture theatre was, indeed, a large piece of cheese. We're hearing that a member of the janitorial staff was seen retrieving the putrid wedge in a hazmat suit, though this particular source has been known to exaggerate. We can only hope the smell dissipates and our community can breathe deeply and cheeselessly once again.
Announcement. Hitting the books doesn't mean what you think it means. Don't eat homework. University gives you a bright future and clouds it with debt. Unattended sandwiches will be eaten by me. Intruders on campus. You know what to do. students are reminded that this is the fun part. Talking on campus. Thank you.
Welcome to the show. I'm Richard E. Hawthorne, and you join me today for 2 Point Radio's Election Day Special. We'll be talking all things mayoral as 2 Point County approaches another important day in its history and indeed its future. Get in touch to tell us what you're thinking and how you're feeling. Who will be the next mayor of 2 Point County? You decide.
We've just completed a marketing project. Students are reminded to find themselves.
We're back. Today's election sees incumbent Mayor Tabitha Winsock take on all challengers. One such foe is Gumbo McNally. Yes, the cousin of Jumbo CEO, Jumbo McNally. Ms. Winsock has held a steady, some say tedious, lead in the polls over Mr. McNally. But what effect, if any, will his last gasp speech have on today's proceedings? If you missed it, Mr. McNally finished a rousing 12-minute display with a story of how he once took a modest pile of change from his father and turned it into an impressive lunchtime spread featuring sandwiches, crisps, and sausage rolls. Oh, now that is impressive.
Students are reminded to have the time of their lives.
From Michelle and Smogley. I spoke to Mayor Winsock after a Q&A once and told her that I'd written her a letter. She said that she remembered reading it, but I'd never sent it to her. So what? Did she break into my house? Or is she, like, telepathic, but just with post? What a lovely anecdote, Michelle. And aren't we lucky to have a mayor that's willing to go above as well as beyond?
Toilets. Lovely. is approaching. It's too late to start trying. Timetable is not written in stone. Still, we're not changing it.
Beaver from Bungle. The small car that makes the little things feel bigger than they are. It's a perspective thing.
Students are reminded to set reminders.
It's election day here in Two Point County. Who else remembers the year they tried to hold the election through a bungle-made phone application? It's amazing to think that we'll never know whether the app didn't work or if no one voted that year. That's the mysterious wonder of pioneering technology. Anyway, here's hoping that this year we'll get some votes in.
If it's not on your CV, it didn't happen. Not to me. Intruders on campus. You know what to do. Students are asked not to ask questions.
Here's a word from Jeffrey in Blyton. I, for one, think things have been a lit, but you know, could they have been better? I think I speak for everyone when I say, yes, maybe they could have. Well, thanks for your time, Jeffrey. Wise words.
Students are reminded that there's no such thing as free time.
The witching hour is almost here, and this journalist's heart is positively beating with legislative excitement. But while we wait for the final count, I'll leave you with this. I spoke to my neighbor last weekend, and he informed me that he never decides his vote until he's in the booth, giving that fateful cross to whichever candidate has the funnier name. Just goes to show we're all a bit of method and all a bit of madness.